What's up, everybody? This is The Fates Have Worn. I'm here to do my review of the next album in the Fates Warning series, The Spectre Within. First of all, I want to tell you before I continue that this is probably going to be the last video in this format. I'm probably going to change it up just... my last review in this format. I'm probably gonna change up the format a bit. I'm gonna try to use Windows Movie Maker a bit more to make a more polished review, as you should say, and I might actually write this stuff down on a script before I actually do anything here, because my videos could be a little less sloppy in ways. So, on to Spectre Within. Now, this is, of course, the second album by Fates Warning. Same exact lineup as the previous. This is a bit more. I definitely have to say that I definitely did like it more than I liked Night Unbroken. Not to say I didn't like Night Unbroken, but this was more consistent overall, and had a few. This one really had some song did have some songs that did stand out a bit more, and there were some songs that are rather kind of I'm not exactly a huge fan of Pirates of the Underground, but I love The Apparition. The Apparition is definitely the best song on this record. It's just epic. it's just an epic track all the way through, and I mean it's just such a well done track. I love the riff, I love the solo, I love the lyrics, I love the vocals. I mean, it's just so well done. This is not... You don't really see the progressive elements quite come in here either. It's slightly more progressive than the previous album, but they don't start coming in... The progressive elements don't start coming in until the next album. And then they really don't start coming in until about Perfect Symmetry. They're in Awaken the Guardian and No Exit, but it's kind of, not exactly emphasized as much as it would be in their later albums. Definitely, I had to say. But definitely, that was a good one. Orphan Gypsy is another really good track off this record. I really wish that they would play some songs off this record live, because it's really too bad that they don't. There's Epitaph. That's pretty much like an Iron Maiden style epic. In a ways, sort of, it's a long song. It's 11 minutes and 58 seconds long. It's the longest song they would make up until, No Exit, when they did, The Ivory Gate of Dreams. And even then, The Ivory Gate of Dreams is kind of several songs thrown into one. So, yep, But yeah, this is a very another nice little epic. Not quite as good as The Apparition, but it's still damn impressive. I can't really say that I liked Without a Trace that much. And not without, wait, I already mentioned Without a Trace. Actually, my fault. I can't really say that I like, Kyrie Eleison that much. Despite the fact that I'm Roman Catholic, it doesn't really hit me musically like the other, it doesn't really tap into me like the other ones did. Records, the other songs on this record did. And Traveler in Time is a pretty good way to start this one out, but it's again, they're a pretty good way to start the record out. But again, it's a little. But overall, I think that this is a pretty good record. It definitely it's a very good record. It's not like spectacular, but again, I think that this is a very good record. Some people like to cite that this as their best record. I could see why, but I personally think, but I don't really think so. This album is kind of just slightly, not completely, but just slightly overrated compared. I'm not saying that this album sucks in any way. I love this album. I mean, not quite as much as the rest, but I love it. But I mean, this is it's slightly inconsistent in a ways too. I mean, there's strong. It has some really strong tracks, I will admit, but it does also have some weaker ones that kind of. The good thing about these ones though is they don't stick out like a sore thumb. They're just kind of. Slightly weaker. I mean, it's not like some of the material. It's not like the stuff that Priest did in the 80s. I mean, those records are good. Some are pretty good records, but there are in pretty much every record except for probably Defenders of the Faith. There are some songs that just really were terrible overall, and they really took away from some of the better stuff on the record, but I can't say that this record sucked in any way at all. I mean, any song on this record sucked in any way at all. I can't say that about Night Unbroken either, but again, Night Unbroken was really just Night Unbroken. The only problem with Night Unbroken was I didn't really think that that anything really stood out there. I mean, all the songs were good, but they weren't like really didn't like just kind of come into. They weren't just like instant classics, I would say. Here, this has some tracks that are just instant classics. Again, The Apparition, Epitaph, Orphan Gypsy. Those are definitely the three best tracks on this record. And these tracks, as well as the others, but these tracks in particular make this record a really worthy listen. It was reissued in 2002 by Metal Blade, again. Featured songs called Radio Underground, I've never heard exactly, but I'm gonna assume that it's a live version, and it's also called Live Underground, which I'm gonna guess it's a live version of Pirates of the Underground. It's got demos of The Apparition, Kyrie Eleison, and Epitaph, so that's pretty cool too. And of course the thing about demos though, when you look at demos, I mean, sometimes the demos of earlier songs are very good, but sometimes they need to they take time to adjust. And pretty much the whole point of demos really is just to get the song out there and to make sure that you've got that is really just to get songs out there and get them as proposals. It's the record where I see where people really try to actually make the song really work. There's only really one demo that I found was actually somewhat better than the original, better than the one that was released on the album, and that was a demo version of Last Rites, Love to Death by Megadeth. That was a very, very good, very good demo. I love that demo. But I would have to say that this is definitely a worthy listen. It's not their best record, but it's in no ways one of their worst. It shows more potential. It's good, but it's not great. I mean, it's not great. It's very good. It's very good, but it doesn't really. It's not really like. It doesn't. It wasn't quite a true instant classic, but it's a worthy listen. I'll admit. This is one that's definitely worth your time listening to, and if you ever see this in a record store, pick it up. It's a record that's gonna stick with you for a while. Some of the tracks aren't as memorable as others, but even then, the tracks that aren't really that memorable are also pretty damn good. So, I definitely would say, I'd probably give this overall an 88%. Some people might be backlashing, say, oh, they probably should have gotten higher, but as much as I like this, I didn't quite like this as much as some of their other records, and, I felt that it was, not quite to the place where they need to be. But, this is a great record. All the musicians perform well. Pretty much after this is the first, lineup change that will be the first lineup change that Fate 20 will ever go through. Original guitarist Vic Arduini, he left the band, and he was replaced by guitarist Frank Oresti, and who pretty much stayed with the band until pretty much the band kind of broke up after Inside Out. So he pretty much stayed with them through Inside Out, and then left to do his own thing, and now he's back in the band. But Frank Oresti, and. So yeah, the next album in the series will be Awaken the Guardian, and this is the album where I think Fate's Warning went from being a good band to an excellent band. This was the album that really I felt, Awaken the Guardian was really the album that I felt that Fate's really put all their effort into it and made a fantastic record. So yes, be prepared for that. I am prepared for that. I've got nothing but good things to say about that record. It's not my favorite, but it's damn close, I'll tell you that much. All right, I'll see you later then.